Hi guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to install Bliss OS alongside Windows 11 for a dual boot setup. Bliss OS lets you enjoy Android on your PC, and setting it up as a dual boot means you can use both Windows and Bliss OS on the same system. So let's get started. First, you need two things to download. You need to download the Bliss OS ISO file and the Rufus software to make a bootable type. So open your favorite browser and search for Bliss OS download. And from the search result, open Bliss OS original official site. On the home page, click on the download button. And here you will get different version: Bliss OS 14, Bliss OS 15, Bliss OS 16, which is a beta version, and a Bliss OS Zenith, which is not recommended for daily use. Here I am going to use Bliss OS 15, which is the stable version of Bliss OS. And I recommend setting the version with G apps, that means Google apps, for maximum compatibility. So click on the source force tab under download, and it will redirect you to source force site. From here, select the Bliss OS ISO file, and after 5 seconds, your download will start automatically. As you can see, the size may be around 1.9 GB, so it might take some time depending on your internet speed. You need to wait for the time to finish. I have already downloaded that file earlier, so I'm going to stop this downloaded process. And this is the downloaded ISO file. Next, we need Rufus software. For that, once again open your favorite browser, and this time you need to search for Rufus download and visit the Rufus official website. Now scroll down little bit and you will get download section. So if you want, you can download the portable version of Rufus. This version runs directly and does not require installation. Okay, so it's a very small size, so within a fraction of a second files get downloaded. Great, now we have everything we need to start the setup. Now let's create a Bliss OS bootable USB using the 32 GB USB drive. So insert the 32 GB USB drive into your PC and then open Rufus, and you will see the USB drive is detected automatically. Now click select and choose the Bliss OS ISO files you downloaded earlier. Here I am going to keep the partition scheme as GPT, as my system uses UEFI partition. You can choose MBR if you have legacy BIOS, okay. And keep other settings as default and then click on start. Rufus will warn you that all data on the USB will be erased. Confirm by clicking OK. Rufus will now create the bootable Bliss OS installer. This process might take few minutes. Once the process is complete, your USB drive is now bootable with Bliss OS. Before we install Bliss OS in our system, we need to make some spaces on our hard drive. Here you can see I have only two drives in my PC. I don't have any free space, so that's why I'm going to make another partition in C drive. Okay, so for that, right click on the start button and select Disk Management. Find your Windows drive, usually C. So I'm going to right click on it and select shrink volume. Now you need to wait for a few seconds here. You need to decide how much space you want to allocate for Bliss OS. So I'm going to make 50 GB for that. So now I'm going to open my calculator and type 50 into 1024, that means 51200. I'm going to enter the amount 51200 in MB and click shrink. This will create an unallocated space of 50 GB where Bliss OS will be installed. Okay. After that, you need to restart your computer and enter the BIOS or UEFI setting, usually by pressing a key like F2, F10 and Dell during boot. So you can check your computer manual for the exact key. Okay. In my case, it is a Dell key. In the BIOS UEFI settings, you need to navigate to the boot menu and select boot option priorities and set your USB drive as the primary boot service. That means in my case here it is boot option 1. Then click on save and exit. Then double click on save and exit setup and click on yes to save the changes we made. Your computer should now boot from the USB drive. When the Bliss OS installer loads, you need to choose the option Bliss OS installation using the arrow key and press enter. After entering, this option will come up by default. You have to press OK here. After that, these options will appear. Here, it is asking to select EFI system partition. So, I will have to create a new partition. So, select create or modify partition using the keyboard arrows in the installer menu. Now, you have to select your hard drive from here. Here, I will select my hard drive volume 1. And press enter. No, continue to save disk. Now you have to select the free space which was 50 GB partition using the arrow key. And then press enter on new. Now create a new 1 GB partition. So for that type 1G and hit enter. You can see that our 1 GB partition has been created. Now by selecting this 1 GB partition, in the below you can see an options type. So select the type as EFI system partition. Now use the remaining space to create another partition. Okay, so select new and use the remaining space and hit enter and set its type as Linux file system. Then write the partition table by selecting write. Then type yes and hit enter. Select quit to exit from the partition manager. You just have to click on OK and then again on OK. Here you will see all the partitions. You need to select the first unknown partition 6 in my case using arrow key, which is a 1 GB where my first EFI system will be created. Then hit enter. It's asking to select a file system to format partition 6. So you need to format it as FAT32. Then press enter on the drive name ESP. Are you sure to format the partition 6? Press yes to proceed. Then select the partition 7, which is in my case 49 GB, and hit enter. And the same way you need to format it as a ext4. Then press enter on the drive name Bliss OS. Are you sure to format the partition? Press yes to proceed. Now formatting the partition going on. After that, you should enable OTA updates for future Bliss OS updates. Select yes and press enter. In the next step, you need to choose GDAP EFI as the bootloader and hit enter. The installation process will now begin. This might take a few minutes. Once it's done, you will see a confirmation message that Bliss OS is installed successfully. And you will get two options here. Either you can run the Bliss OS directly or reboot the system. Now I am going to remove the USB drive and after that reboot the system. After the system reboots, you will see an interface like this. The first option represents the Bliss OS we just installed. Okay, and the bottom you will notice the Windows options, which lets you boot back into the Windows system. For now, I will select the first option and press enter to launch Bliss OS. After the Bliss OS logo appears, you will need to go through some basic setup steps. Follow the on-screen instruction to complete the initial setup, such as choosing a dock layout, granting permission for displaying over other apps, and signing it to your Google accounts. Once done, Bliss OS will be fully installed. Now we can explore its features, install apps from the Play Store, and enjoy a complete Android experience on your computer. Next, I'm going to restart the system to check if I can boot into Windows without any issue. Okay, so simply restart your system, and when the boot menu appears, now this time you need to select the last option, which is for Windows. You will see that it boots into Windows smoothly without any problem. That's it guys, now you have successfully installed Bliss OS alongside Windows in a dual boot setup and you can switch between Windows and Bliss OS anytime you like. If you found this guide helpful, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and let me know in the comments if you have any question. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.